Costa Rica has many beautiful rivers. The Toro River is one of them, who has its basin in the province Limon. But actually, this river should be placed in the stream category, compared to other rivers in Costa Rica. The Toro River has its sources on the slopes of the Talamanca mountain range. Previously, this river drains the water directly into the Caribbean Sea, but is linked now to the Martina River by a channel. On its way to the Caribbean Sea, this river is fed by a few small streams. And these streams are beautiful cichlid habitats. Often these streams cross the roads through a culvert. At the outlet of the culverts are deep washed out pits often formed. Where water is, there is a vegetation. A large area around the pool was then also covered with beautiful vegetation. The life bearers species Pusillia foraged here in the underwater vegetation, but also small cichlids that find an excellent shelter with sufficient food supply. But let's take a look at the underwater world of this small drainage basin, which was caused by heavy rainfall. Here too, in most places the vegetation on the banks has grown into the pool. The stream that feeds this basin carries brilliant clear water, in which, at first glance, a large stock of fish swims. Astyanax mexicanus swims around in large numbers, waiting for food to be carried by the stream, especially around the places where the water from the stream drops into the pool. I estimated the pool to be between 4 and 5 meters in diameter, with a depth of up to 3 meters. As I mentioned it before, the water is super clear, so I even had a good view to the bottom of the pool. The bottom of the pool was originally covered with river boulders of various sizes, and it's clearly visible that the sand has been pushed up from the bottom of the pond during heavy rainfall. Besides the Astyanax, I also saw several cichlid species swimming in the depth. But as I looked into the shallower parts of the pool, the concentration of cichlids increased. I think that the greater concentration of cichlids in the shallower parts of the pool has to do with several factors. The sun penetrates to the boulders, creating a rich layer of algae, where various cichlids can feast on. But also the bank vegetation and roots that have grown in the water offer a good hiding places where cichlids can always be found. Several different species pass by my camera, such as Cryprohyrus alvari, Paragromus dovi and Amatitlania septem fasciata. From the last mentioned, I would like to tell you more about in this video. Amatitlania septem fasciata was officially described by Regan in 1908. But after several name changes, this species was finally placed in the genus Amatitlania by Schmitter and Soto in 2007. The distribution of Amatitlania septem fasciata reached from the border river San Juan of Nicaragua to the Rio Banano south of Limon, and only in the Atlantic sites up to 600 meters in altitude, where it inhabits the shallower parts of the shady rainforest rivers. This cichlid, which remains small, can often be recognized by having two dark spots on the flank. Above these black spots, the fish has a green-yellow color that also covers its entire head. Below the spots, the fish has a sky blue color, depending on its mood. Also related to his state of mind is the visibility of 6 vertical stripes, from which his name is derived. While snorkeling in the pool, I wondered if there is also such a large concentration of Amatitlania septem fasciata in the Toro River itself. Pusillia mexicana occurs here in large numbers. The male of the species show his dorsal fin to impress the female. The riverbed here is also richly covered with river boulders, from where suddenly a Tomo Sigla tuba appeared. By the way, the Toro River is the most southeastern river in which I encountered Tomo Sigla tuba, and that also applies to Paragromus dovi. Occasionally, some Amatitlania septem fasciata swims around, but not in such large concentrations as earlier in the pool. Amatitlania septem fasciata is a true omnivore, insects and their larvae, small fish, snails, but also detritus and algae are on the menu. By coincidence, I found a pair of Amatitlania septem fasciata in breeding dress, who guides their offspring along the slopes of the riverbed. During the mating season, the color pattern of the pair changes dramatically. Then it is mainly the black and white tones that predominate. At this stage, the two spots and the six vertical stripes are clearly visible. But let's go back to the pool, where we will go a little further into their breeding behavior. The sex of this species is not difficult to determine. The males grow to about 10 centimeters, while the females do not grow larger than 7 centimeters. And the females are easy to recognize by a multiple dorsal fin spot. Amatitlania septem fasciata is closely related to Amatitlania myrnae and Amatitlania saiyica. And all species out of the genus Amatitlania are cave breeders. Like all Amatitlania, Amatitlania septem fasciata is then also a cave spawner. The female deposits, depending on her size, up to 200 eggs in a clean vertical surface of the cave. Depending on the water temperature, the larvae hatched after 3 days and will start free swimming after about 7 days. The males are sexually mature at 6 cm, the females at 4 cm. The temperament of this fish does not keep up with the size. The fish are much feisty than you will expect, especially during the mating season. The character of these dwarfs can be called enormous, and they often manage to raise offspring even in crowded habitats like this. Both parents care for the fry intensively, from the time the female deposits the eggs until the young go their separate ways after several weeks. The offspring remain in a dense cloud under the female, while the male defends the direct environment. He does this with verve and does not shy away from much bigger opponents. I am convinced that this species like to breed in small breeding colonies. I have found small colonies in several rivers in Costa Rica, and even in this pool, 3 pairs are breeding in one corner of the pool. And this in a range of only a few square meters. You can regularly see how they stir up the bottom segment with their pelvic and pectoral fins. A nice feature to see that they offer their young food in this way. And even leaves are occasionally turned over by the female to offer shrimp eggs for the offspring. Amatitlania septem fasciata is not a difficult aquarium fish, but do need oxygen-rich water. Amatitlania septem fasciata can be kept well with other Central American fish. Combinations with medium-sized species such as Cryprohyrus alfari are no problem if you consider an aquarium of at least 1 meter in size. How beautiful would it be if you were sitting in front of your aquarium and a breeding pair like this swimming around over richly algae-covered river boulders. Beautiful imitated, as in their natural habitat.